Hi everyone! I was recently contacted by the Delve Bros, who asked if I would review their upcoming game, Taelmoor, a cooperative, narrative, dungeon-crawling adventure. I agreed, but when it arrived, I discovered it's a board game that requires app integration in order to play. This made me a little hesitant, since app-based games aren't always well-received in the tabletop community. People worry they'll have limited lifespans if publishers stop supporting them through future mobile firmware upgrades. The more I thought about it, the more I agreed. If I review this game now and someone goes to watch it in the distant future, there's a good chance it could be completely irrelevant. So, in order to be thorough, I decided I'd have to base my review 200 years in the future, when the creators of the game are no longer alive and support for the app has long ended. Now, without further ado, here is my futuristic review of Taelmoor. Hi everyone, and Congredump Smattlebomb, which, as you know, is the customary greeting we all use here in the year 2221. Today, I'll be taking a look at the extremely dated 200-year-old game, Taelmoor. In Taelmoor, players explore dungeons and underground lairs while battling and befriending the odd inhabitants within. To start, players are supposed to open up the Taelmoor app on their mobile device. However, this is currently impossible, since mobile devices no longer exist. I tried to load the app by staring at this ancient hieroglyphic, but unfortunately, my XRQ mind chip was unable to process it. You're supposed to select a scenario from within the app in order to start the game. So without the app, I was forced to just make one up on my own. I took a look at the game components to help me come up with something, and decided the scenario would be about venturing into a dungeon to find my long-lost shirt. I personally found this scenario to be a bit lame, but since I'm not a naturally creative person, it was the best I could do without the publisher's direction. Next, I had to pick a character. I chose the barbarian, placed the card in front of me, but oddly, nothing happened. This was a major letdown. As you all know, as soon as you pick a character in any modern 2221 board game, a 4D solid hologram envelops your body and physically turns you into that character, giving your brain all of their memories and their skills. It was incredibly boring having to read the barbarian's backstory and stats, and I truly don't understand how anyone from the past could have ever felt immersed this way. After this, I began to play, exploring the dungeon, looking for my lost shirt. I went room to room to room, and after only 5 minutes, I had every single dungeon tile out on the table, but literally nothing had happened. There are obviously tons of monsters, characters, and items that are supposed to be in the game, but not a single one of them automatically spawned. Now, I don't know if the component teleportation technology is broken, or if this game was made before that technology even existed, which I doubt since that tech is so old at this point. But regardless, this was the most uneventful dungeon I had ever been in. Just to experiment, I put a monster out onto the board, but it just sat there motionless like an idiot. Even worse, without the app, I had no idea what its stats were. I connected to the Universal Mind Bank and tried to telepathically contact the brains of the Delve Bros to see if they could at least tell me what stats would have been in the app. However, their brains unfortunately were already completely dead, and they must not have been very smart since not a single one of them had their consciousness cryogenically preserved. Without any stats, I was able to defeat the monster in one punch, and with nothing else to go on, I decided that it had stolen my lost shirt. So I picked it up and won the game. I was victorious, but I was also very, very bored. So, with a heavy heart, I unfortunately cannot recommend Taelmoor, and I can confirm that app-based games simply are not worth the money. Why should I spend $60 on something if there's no guarantee it's going to be functional for at least a few centuries? And I know some people make the argument that you can go out for a nice dinner and easily drop $150 in a single night, so it shouldn't be a big deal to pay $60 for a game that will entertain you for a few years. But to those people, I have this to say. If you go out for a nice dinner, the food you eat gets turned into poop. That poop can become fertilizer, and that fertilizer can grow into a tree that will live for 1,000 years. So in my opinion, your comparison is stupid.